Hey there! If you've been following Blazing SEO, you might be wondering, who the heck is this? Well, I'm Allie, and 1 year ago, I didn't know jack about proxies, let alone how to choose between data center or residential ones. But that's the great thing about proxies, and the even greater thing about Blazing SEO. You don't have to know everything there is to know about proxies to start using them and gaining the incredible value out of them. As your proxy partner, we're going to be here with you every step of the way because we believe in the power of proxies. Today, I want to weigh in on a conversation that can honestly be kind of tricky. Data center proxies versus residential proxies. Why do I say it's tricky? Well, it brings up some concepts that many proxy providers tend to avoid, including ethics. But like I said, if these terms don't make any sense to you yet, that's okay. You don't have to know everything there is to know about proxies to start getting value out of them. But if there is one thing you should know, it's the difference between your average proxy and a great proxy, and the difference between your average proxy provider and a great ethical proxy provider. So let's get started. The first question is, what are proxies? To understand the answer to this question, you should know that every internet connection is assigned an IP address. This IP address helps website owners and other internet users have a general idea of who's accessing their website, where they're accessing it from, and what kind of device they're using. But what if you don't want websites and other internet users to know this information about you? That's where proxies come in. A proxy is an IP address that acts as a middleman between your actual IP address and the website you're trying to access. This gives you an extra layer of security, anonymity, and access to the internet overall. So instead of the website being able to see your actual IP address, it sees the proxy IP address instead. And for the most part, this is still the same content you could access with that home connection. But now, there's that extra layer of security and anonymity that people really enjoy. In fact, those are the main benefits of using a proxy. But what are some others? One has to do with something called geolocation. Choosing the geolocation of your proxies really enhances your experience. Here's how it works. A proxy provider will allow you to choose the location of your proxies so that whenever you connect with those proxies, it appears as though you are actually in that location. This allows you to stream content, access web data, and do just about anything else from anywhere in the world. For instance, even though you might be in Germany, you might want to access content that's only available in California. So, you can get a proxy IP address from California to access that content. Want to stream foreign films and shows? Access global content so you can conduct better brand research? Simply avoid bans, which we'll talk about later? You can do all of this and more by choosing certain geolocations for your proxies. So now that we have a general definition of proxies, let's talk about some common types and reasons that people may or may not want to use proxies for their use case. You know, the reason you probably started watching this video to begin with. So the first type of proxy I want to talk about are data center proxies. What are they, and what are some pros and cons? Data center proxies are probably the most common type of proxy. And if you're familiar with this conversation about proxies, they're probably the type of proxy that pops into your head when you hear the word proxy. These IP addresses are affiliated with a proxy provider's data center, not an internet service provider or ISP. This means that even though websites can't see your actual IP address, they can still identify that the proxy you're using is coming from a data center. And that leads to one of the main problems people run into when using data center proxies. They're more likely to get banned. Even though they're less reliable, data center proxies are typically more affordable than residential proxies, and you don't have to pay extra for bandwidth. What's bandwidth? Not to be confused with internet or data speed, bandwidth is the volume of data that can be transmitted over a connection. If you have a super high volume use case for your proxies, companies can charge you extra for this, just because they can. But not Blazing SEO. Data center proxies are easier to buy in bulk, making larger projects much more manageable. And for most use cases, they really can open door after door after door. Ever heard of web scraping? It's likely something you encounter every single day. If you've ever copied and pasted a link from one of your favorite websites, you've performed web scraping. If you've ever copied the number of followers and following from one of your favorite social media accounts, you've performed web scraping. But what do data center proxies have to do with all of that? In short, they make web scraping a whole lot easier. Sure, if you have 10 minutes to scroll through those social media accounts to get general ideas for your brand, you probably don't need a proxy. But what if you're a brand manager who doesn't need 10 minutes, but 1,010 minutes every single day to get the social media data you need? Who doesn't have time to scroll through every social media account, every about me page, every comment, every like, every follower, every... Oh, so that doesn't sound fun? Tell me about it. So what about residential proxies? What do they have to do with all of this? Like I said, data center proxies are not associated with an internet service provider or ISP. Residential proxies are. This means that if a website owner were to look into the details of the residential proxy that you're using, they would be able to tell that it's associated with an internet service provider instead of that data center. This means that even though you're using a proxy, it looks as though you're a regular human just browsing the web. And since website owners don't want to risk banning real users from accessing their websites, you are way less likely to get banned by using residential proxies. And if you're trying to do a lot of web scraping or collect a lot of data, this is a big deal. With residential proxies, you can scrape the web quickly and at scale. Without the right kind of proxies and resources for your use case, you can get banned from these websites real quick. But that's not because it's illegal. It's just because they don't like robots. But honestly, they have good reason not to like it when bots access their data using proxies. Even though proxies are used every single day for good, there are too many people out there who use it for bad. Think spamming, malware, stealing private info, and the like. Real talk, Blazing SEO does not condone or allow any such activity. In fact, our system is set up to immediately detect any illegal or fraudulent behavior, and we collaborate with local law enforcement in all such cases. Don't do it. So if you're gonna scrape, pay attention to terms of services, or things could end badly. And if you're gonna use residential proxies to do it, use them to do it goodly. So how do you decide between data center versus residential proxies? Well, data center proxies are a lot easier to buy in bulk, which makes it great if you're on a budget. If your proxy provider offers a diverse range of C-class IPs, you can still avoid bans. Designed for company use and even more helpful for SEO, C-class subnets with high diversity can help make up for data center proxies' relative lack of authority. But if you're an enterprise-level company that relies on the highest quality data to keep your business going, you need residential proxies. They're more reliable, and if they're ethically sourced, they can offer your brand the highest level of protection. Unethical proxy sellers can obtain residential IPs illicitly, sometimes stealing them from ISPs and selling them for a profit. If you bought these proxies and your seller gets caught, you could lose all of those proxies, even though you had nothing to do with that illegal transaction. Too often, big proxy companies, even some well-known ones, will pitch shadily sourced IPs at competitive costs because their resident users either A, weren't adequately compensated, or B, didn't even know that their IPs were being resold because they didn't understand what they were signing up for. This is called unethical IP sourcing, and unfortunately, it's all too common. However, that doesn't have to be the case. So how can you tell if you're using ethically sourced IPs? Regardless of the type of proxy you're using, if your proxy provider isn't absolutely, positively, 100% in your face clear about how they source their IPs, you don't want to buy proxies from them. Blazing SEO is blazing the trail as the ethical proxy provider in our industry. And whether or not you decide to go with residential proxies or data center proxies, you can rest easy at night knowing exactly where our proxies come from and what resident users are signing up for when they partner with us. Visit blazingseollc.com to start using our data center proxies today, or to sign up to see if you qualify for our residential proxy beta. That's blazingseollc.com. Thanks so much for sticking with me. I hope I've been able to fill you up with all the proxy knowledge you need to start gaining value out of these incredible resources. Wait a second. That's better. But in all seriousness, we know that this conversation can be tricky, especially if you're still not sure about all this proxy stuff. As your proxy partner, Blazing SEO is here for you. Hop on over to our website and check out our blog articles on types of proxies, use cases, and ways that proxies are used for good every single day. You can even download our ebook and become a proxy expert practically overnight. Feel free to reach out to our excellent customer support team with any other questions you might have, or drop a comment below. I'm so excited to dive deeper into this world of proxies with you, so keep an eye out for our next video.